Student, today we are going to learn general machine structures. Here we have one general machine structure that is again called as a IBM 360 machine structures. Consists of different part: instruction interpreter, instruction register that is called as IR, locations counter that is called as LC, memory buffer register that is called as MBR, MAR, memory address registers, memory controller, working registers, general purpose registers, instruction interpreter, and IO channels. Now, one by one, we are going to see the different part of IBM 360 machine structures or different components of IBM 360 machine structures. Now, here we have first that is called as a locations counter. What indicate the locations counter? LC is again called as a program counter, which identify the current locations of instructions or current executions locations of that particular instructions. Next, what indicate the instruction register that is called as again IR. Instruction register contain the instructions which fetch the copy of instruction from MBR and store it. After that, we have that is called as an instruction interpreter. Instruction interpreter decode the instruction stored in the instruction register. What indicate the decode of instructions? Suppose we have any instructions such as a move A, B or 2, 3 or any instructions. At that condition, the instruction is what types of instruction, whether it is add instructions, whether it is multiply instruction, whether it is branch instruction. So that instructions is interpreted by instruction interpreter. It is a functions of instruction interpreter whose address is stored in MAR and content is stored in MBR. Now we can take with the one example. First, if we have the load instructions, and that instruction is stored in 500 locations. At same time, what is the address? 500. That 500 address is stored in memory address registers and content load 2, 3 or move A, B. That content or instructions is stored in memory buffer registers. After that, we have memory controller. Memory controller is used to coordinate the functions of MBR. MBR contains the instructions or data. That data is stored in core memory locations. That is functions of or coordinate the functions of MBR and core memory locations to transfer the data. Now, here again we have that is called as the IO channel. IO channel is used to connect with the outside world or to connect with the different types of outside devices. MBR contain the address, MBR contain the values. That values or instructions is fetched in IR and stored of and perform the functions, different functions of additions, any phase of functions perform in the working registers. And output of that functions or instruction is stored in general purpose registers. There are R0 to R15 general purpose registers which are used by the programmer. So it is a generalized functions of IBM 360 machines. Now, here we have instruction interpreter, locations counter, instruction register, working register, general purpose registers. Instruction interpreter is used to decode the instruction fetched from the memory. Already we have seen. Now we have locations counter. Locations counter or LC is identified the locations of current instructions. What will be the locations of current instruction? Again, it is called as a program counter or PC or instructions counter. Next, instruction register. Instruction registers load the instruction which is the content of LC stored in IR. Next here we have that is called as a working register or memory device that serve as a scratch pad for instruction interpreter. Again we have that is called as a general purpose register. Already we have seen that general purpose registers start from R0 to R16 and it is a 32 bit word size. Now we have memory address register that is called as MAR. Contain the address of memory locations. Already we have seen that 500 is stored in the memory MAR and the content is stored in the MBR. And what are the content of that particular locations is stored in the MBR. Memory control is a hardware device that work is to transfer the content of the MBR to the core memory locations whose address is stored in the MAR. Now we have that is called as an I/O channel. I/O channel is used to connect with the outside world, or it may be to separate the computer which interpret the special instruction for inputting and outputting informations from memory. Now before that we have learned the IBM 360 machine structures. That machine structure we have to going to relate with the any instructions such as the add instructions and see the flowchart with example. Now what indicate the IC? IC indicate the instruction counter or instruction counter. So what are the current instruction location? That address is first stored in MAR, that is called as a memory address registers. Now that address contain the instructions or data. In this case, first here we have the instructions. That instruction is stored in memory buffer registers. Here you can see MBR, MAR, that is called as a read the instruction from the memory. Afterward, the content of MBR, it may be data, it may be instructions, that is fetch into the instruction register, that is put the instruction in instruction register, then identify the type of instructions, whether it is add instructions, whether it is subtract instruction, whether it is multiply instruction, whether it is branch instruction or any others. Here we have identified it is a type of add instructions. Now if we take the example add 2, 3, here first we have to identify the locations of that particular content. Here we have identified by IR is stored in the MAR, address of that particular content MAR. Now that first content MAR contain the address and that address contain the content that stored in the MBR. Now the instruction register content is to work with the working register or fetch in the working registers and perform the additions of that two number, that is first number is stored in the working registers and the second number is stored in the memory buffer register. Here perform the additions and in working registers. Now it always need to store result in registers. Now that result is stored in instruction register or registers. Always after performing the functions or after completing the additions of two number, always it need to increment the pointer. That pointer is incremented by IC plus 1. So IC plus 1 increment the pointer to perform the next instruction. Thank you.